Ja, Nico, ik ga iets doen wat ik eigenlijk nooit doe tijdens een programma. Ik ga even onder tafel kijken. Wacht even.
Oh jee.
Doe het niet aan.
Ja, ik zie dat jij een korte broek draagt.
Ja, heerlijk.
Rick, ik kijk. Nou, ik hoef niet nog. Ik heb het al gezien. Jij draagt een lange broek.
Ja, klopt.
Hoe voelt dat?
Ja, best wel kut, maar dat moet wel. Ik moet nog werken straks.
Oké, maar je had een korte broek mee, maar dat maakt verder niet uit. Nee. Nico, korte broek, waarom?
Ja, 40 graden zeg genoeg, toch?
Jij zegt 40 graden zeg genoeg. Korte broek is dan lekker cool.
Precies.
Ik heb iemand aan de lijn die het daar niet mee eens is. Je had namelijk ook een kilt kunnen dragen. Heb je al eens een kilt gedragen?
Nee, jij wel?
Ik heb nog nooit een kilt gedragen. Rick, ja, jij wel, hè?
Nou, wel een minirok, maar geen kilt.
Oké, okay, wel een minirok, maar geen kilt. Nou, daar kunnen we het ook even over hebben, want dat staat in zijn mail. We kregen een mailtje van Patrick. En Patrick die stuurde een mailtje van... waarom zou je een korte broek dragen als je ook een kilt kunt dragen? Rick spreekt alleen, of Patrick spreekt alleen Engels. Zo, dus we moeten het interview even in het Engels gaan doen.
Succes.
Ja, nee, als je wat wil weten, dan mag het.
Ik ben heel benieuwd.
Oké, okay, let's see if he's there, Patrick.
Yes, and welcome, listeners.
It's great to talk to you, Patrick. I was already explaining in Dutch, and I will explain it a little bit to you as well, because then you know what we're talking about. We received an email from you about wearing a kilt, and you say, "Well, it feels better, and it's healthier to wear a kilt because you know you leave it all hanging, and it's cool and cold, etc." And then, well, it triggered me a little bit, so I started googling you, and then I found a whole lot of interviews with you. Can you tell me where and when did you start wearing kilts? Because you're doing that every day, right?
Yeah, it's my everyday wear in summer, in winter. It's good for every season.
Okay.
So some don't want to believe that it can be nice in winter, even in Poland, because I'm from Poland.
Yeah.
We have very freezing winters sometimes, and it's no problem to wear kilt.
Okay, so you say you're from Poland. You have very cold winters.
I'm living in the Netherlands. I'm in Oosterwijk now, but right. I'm from Poland.
So you live in Oosterwijk now, but you come from Poland originally.
Yes.
And how? Because I would say, if you wear a kilt, you're from Scotland.
many say that. Oh, Scotland, Ireland, because kilt is connected with those countries. But originally, kilt comes from Scandinavia. I don't know if
originally they come from Scandinavia.
Yeah.
So the people from Sweden were originally wearing kilts.
Sorry.
The people from Sweden and Finland and Denmark and Norway, they were originally the first to start with wearing kilts.
Yeah, they designed this garment. They named it. Is from old Scandinavian. It's from ancient times, from Vikings.
Right. Okay, but then back to you, because you are from Poland, so you're not from Scandinavia. How?
Yeah.
Why did you start wearing kilts every day?
It was about 13 years ago. I was in a metal festival in Czech Republic.
Yeah.
It was hot like today, above 30 degrees.
Yeah.
And I was walking to the festival area and found a shop selling kilts.
Okay.
But there were some shops selling strange clothes for strange people, you know. Yeah. The metal maniacs.
Right.
So I decided to, I buy it and try.
Okay.
I see what happened. And I bought it, put it on, and realized that it's really, really much cooler, much outstanding, comfortable, rather. Right. So I decided to wear it every day.
But okay. What I'm wondering, if you're at a metal festival, it's quite normal to wear a kilt, because very much people
in
there.
Metal festival, yes, back home.
You're also wearing in daily life. Doesn't people look weird at you then, in the streets?
No, even in Poland, some people asking, you are from Scotland, what about you, like folk music? Yes, I like folk music. But kilt is not a part of folk music for me, but it's normal clothes.
It's just normal clothes. Okay. So and then I received your email, and there was like a scientific article in it. There was a woman who investigated the effects of it's called testicular heat stress. So to say it in normal English, what happens down below when it gets too hot, right?
Testicles overheat and it causes the damage of the seminal DNA with all the consequences of this fact.
Right. Okay. And so you're saying it's healthier
for public health.
Yeah, for public health. So actually what you're trying to do is to get every person in the Netherlands to wear a kilt, right?
Not only in the Netherlands, in the world.
In the world.
In Western culture.
Okay.
Yeah, my action is not close to the Netherlands. I sent similar emails to United Kingdom, to France, to Spain, to Poland.
Right. Okay, but now you're talking to the Nijmegen area. So just for the people in Nijmegen, for me, I have never ever worn a kilt. So if you have to convince me, where do I need to start?
Just buy a kilt and put it on and tie.
Okay, but I can never go to work with wearing a kilt. My boss wouldn't accept it.
My boss too. I have problems. I work in on DPD and in Havana, and my boss told no kids.
Yeah.
This is one of the reasons I make this action, because the bosses or ladies of the companies must realize that it's a health issue, it's a public health issue, and people should be allowed to work in kids, to live in kids.
Right.
It's,
okay, so Patrick, can I'm sorry. We have to look at the time as well. Can I give you like 20 seconds now of radio time to give the best argument of wearing a kilt? Why should we all in the Nijmegen area all start wearing kilts from now on?
There are a lot of arguments. For me personally, was the best argument was comfort, because I'm not a scientist. I just realized that that is much more comfortable than trousers, shorts, everything what I worn before. So I simply don't want to back to trousers. I feel it's not right for me if I try to. And I was talking with some other men that started to wear kilts, and it's common for us. We don't want to back to trousers, because the difference in feeling is really huge.
Okay, good to know. So what you're actually saying is it's just comfortable and you just have to try it, and once you've tried it, you will never go back to your shorts.
No, never.
Right.
No way.
That's a very good argument. I want to thank you very much for this interview.
Thank you.
And we have to work until 8, but then maybe I will go and buy a kilt. I think Nico is already enthusiastic. Thank you very much, Patrick.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.